Welcome to Nagesh Karajki Orchid School. I am Abhyasha teacher, teaching you grade 4 science. In previous session, we have started our new topic, that is lesson number 5, the earth and the solar system. We have seen some points from that topic. Before starting new points, we will recall the previous points. Let us see the board. In previous session, we have seen about the stars and the sun. The second point was the planets and the solar system. Let us recall in detail the stars and the sun. The star is a huge ball of a hot glowing gases. The sun is a star nearest to us. Stars appears twinkling spot of light in a night sky. Due to sunlight, they cannot be seen in a day. Now we will see about the planets and solar system. Planets is a large heavenly body. They do not give out light and heat, means they don't have their own light and heat. They move around the sun. Every planet is moving around the sun. The sun is the center of solar system. The planets are in order of increasing distance from the sun. They do not twinkle. Yes, planets, because of they don't have light and heat, they do not twinkle. Some planets have smaller objects called moons. Planets move around sun in a fixed path called orbit. The sun, the planets and moons belong to family of solar system. Yes, the sun, the planet and moon, it is called as, means their family is called solar system. Now we'll see the names of the planets. There are 8 planets in our solar system. The first planet is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. These are 8 planets in our solar system. Now we'll see some facts about planets. Mercury, Venus, Earth, closer to Sun called inner planets. They are made up of rocks. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune away from the Sun, so they are called outer planets. Now we'll see in detail about the planet. The first planet is Mercury. It is nearest to the Sun. Mercury is hot during the day and cold at night. It has no moon. There is very little air around Mercury. Now we'll see about Venus. It is hottest planet in the solar system. It is brightest planet amongst all the planet. It is hottest planet because of that it is the brightest planet also. It is called morning and evening star. Venus do not have any moon. Now we'll see about our third planet, that is Earth. The only planet that have life. It is neither too hot or cold. It has water and air surrounded by it. It has only one moon. Now we'll see about Mars. It is called as red planet. It has red dust that covers it, so it is look like a red. It has two moons. Earth is have one moon. Mars has two moons. Now we'll see about the Jupiter. It is the largest planet in the solar system. Jupiter is largest planet in solar system. It has 67 known moons. It has red spot on it. This red spot is due to the huge storm blowing from ears. Now we'll see about Saturn. It is second largest planet in the solar system. It has 62 known moons. It has many rings around the planet. Now we'll see about the Uranus. It is the third largest planet in the solar system. It has 27 known moons. Now last planet is Neptune. It is very windy planet. Wind blow in this planet because it is called as windy planet. Strong winds blow 2000 kilometers an hour across the planet. It has 14 known moons. So you have seen about the planet. Now we'll see the question. We can see planets as steady point of light in the sky. Why can we see them even though they do not give out light of their own? This question is there in your canopy book, page number 40. Yes, can you tell me? Planets do not have their light, then too we can see them. We'll see the answer. A planet reflects the light of the sun, because of that we can see them. Yes, the sunlight falls on the planet and they are, means the planets reflect the light of sun, because of that we can see them. Now we'll see the second question. Why do think Venus shines brightest when seen from the Earth, even though there are other planets that are much bigger? Once again I will read. Why do you think Venus shines brightest when seen from the earth, even though there are other planets that are much bigger? Yes, we'll see the answer. As Venus is the planet closest to the earth, because of that we can see. Now we will see the new points from lesson number 5, that is earth and the solar system. In this lesson we are going to learn about the earth and how the earth moves. Our first point, the earth. Yes, can you tell me which fruit it is? Yes, everybody know it is watermelon. What is the color of this watermelon? Yes, it is in green in color. But inside it is green in color? No, when you will cut the watermelon, you will see the different color inside it. Right? Outside it is green in color, but inside it is having, the pulp is having red color, and even cover is having two colors. You can see in this picture, green color, white color and red color. Like this, our earth is having the different covers inside it. We'll see which are those. Many years ago, when the earth was formed, it was very hot. Yes, when the first time the earth was formed, it was very hot. But afterwards, rains and thunderstorms cool the outer surface of earth and different life forms started on earth surface. Yes, afterwards what happened, due to the rains and thunderstorm, the outer side of the earth become cool and the life start on the earth surface. The earth is a huge ball of a rock. Inside the earth there are many rocks. It is made up of rock. We live on the outer surface of the earth, which is cool and has conditions suitable for life. Yes, just now I have told you, because of rains and thunderstorm, the life forms. Yes, we live the outer side of a earth. There are different surface, or inside it the different part is there, we will see. This thin outer surface called crust. The outer surface of a earth is called crust. Earth crust covered with landforms, water and air. But the earth is not same inside. Yes, inside it is different. We will see now. Below the crust, the mantle is there, means mantle layer is there, which is very hot and made up of almost molten rocks. Inside the crust there is molten rock. Molten means the substance that melt or change into liquid by heating. In the center is the core. It is divided into two parts, inner core and outer core. Inner core is in solid state and outer core is liquid in state. We get metals from this part of the earth. Yes, we get the metals from the core part. In inner core, metals are in solid form, and in outer core, metals are in liquid form. It is very hottest part of the earth. Yes. Now you will get the surface. First, outer surface is crust, followed by the mantle, then it followed by outer core, and inside outer core there is a inner core. Inside inner core we get the metal in a solid state, and in outer core we get metals in the form of liquid state. You may have heard of volcano's eruption. Yes, you know the volcano's eruption. Volcanoes erupting means sending hot lava out from inner part of the earth and causing great damage. Volcanoes are actually cracks or holes in the crust of the earth. Yes, means outer side of the earth there are holes and cracks because of the volcanoes. Molten rocks called magma. It is sometimes forced out from the mantle of the earth through these cracks and holes. Yes, you can see in this picture the earth crust has cracks or holes. From that magma, lava is coming. The magma that flows out is called lava. When it will come out from the core, it is called as lava. It is red hot and hardens to form rock on cooling. This shows how hot the earth is deep inside. Yes, you can see in this picture that red color is called as lava. When it will cool down, it is converted into the rock. It will become hard and it forms a rock. Now we'll see the quick review of about the earth. It is huge ball of a rock. We live on the outer surface of the earth. The conditions are suitable for life. Thin layer is called the crust, or outer layer is called crust. Below the crust is the mantle layer, which is very hot and made up of molten rocks. The center is the core. It is hottest part of the earth. Volcanoes are cracks or holes in the crust of the earth. Molten rocks called magma. Magma flows out called lava. When the magma flows out from the earth, from inside the earth to outside, it is called as lava. Now we'll see how the earth moves. The earth is always moving planet. It spins like a top and at the same it travels around the sun. Means the earth moves around itself and it is also travels around the sun. The earth moves by rotates on its axis and revolves around the sun. Means it will move around or it will rotate on its axis also and revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun. Yes. Revolution of earth causes season. When the earth moves around the sun, it causes season. Now we'll see the earth rotates on its axis or how the earth rotates on its axis. The spinning movement of the earth is called rotation. You can see in this picture the earth spins around it is called rotation. It appears to spin around a line passing through its center. The spins in a similar way around an imaginary line passing through its center. This imaginary line passes through the north and south pole of the earth. One imaginary line is passing through its center. That line is passing through the north and south pole of the earth. It is called the axis of rotation. Yes, upside it is north pole, down it is south pole, and that one imaginary line is passing through the center of the earth. It is called the axis of rotation. The earth complete one rotation in 24 hours. Yes, one round is completed in 24 hours. The rotation of the earth causes day and night. Yes, when the earth rotates, that time it causes day and night, and the duration is 24 hours. Now we'll see about the earth revolves around the sun. The earth moves around the sun in a fixed path called orbit. Yes, you know this. We have seen in the last session also, the earth moves around the sun in fixed path called orbit. That green color round is called orbit. This movement of the earth is called revolution. When the earth moves around the sun, it is called revolution. The earth revolves around the sun once in about 365 days or 1 year. One round, it is about 365 days or we can say 1 year. When the earth complete one round, it takes 365 days to complete that round or 1 year to complete that whole round. Now we'll see the revolution of the earth causes season. You know that weather changes throughout the year. Yes, sometimes it is windy, sometimes it is summer, sometimes it is raining. It is hot during summer months and cold in a winter months. Days are longer in a summer than winter. This happens because of revolution. Yes, because of the revolution, the earth moves around the sun. Because of that, summer and winter days are coming. There is an imaginary line which divides the earth into two halves, the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. This line is called equator. Yes, you can see in this picture, the center of the earth is called equator. Upside it is north pole, down it is south pole. The upside part it is called northern hemisphere and downside part it is called southern hemisphere. India is in the northern hemisphere, whereas Australia is in the southern hemisphere. When the earth revolves around the sun, it is tilted to one side. When the north pole tilts towards the sun, the northern hemisphere gets more sunlight and has a summer. When the north pole is near tilted towards the sun, that time that part or north pole is having summer. At this time, the south pole is tilted away from the sun. The southern hemisphere gets less sunlight and that time it has winter in a southern hemisphere. So when it is summer in India, it is winter in Australia. After a few months, when the earth reaches the other side of the sun, the south pole is tilted towards the sun and the north pole is tilted away from the sun. Means it will happen opposite. So the southern hemisphere has summer and northern hemisphere has winter. I hope you have understood the today's points. You go through the lesson thoroughly, and if you have doubt, just underline the difficult words and note down. In next session, we are going to solve the exercise and we will recall all the points. Thank you.